Part 5, Wiring Up. Now it's time to mount the controller housing. Preferably mounted away from direct sunlight at a comfortable working height. It should also be out of range of garden sprinklers and be easily accessible even when the gates are open. With the controller housing fitted, it's time to do the wiring. Before proceeding with the wiring, ensure that the main supply to the unit is properly isolated. The main supply terminates onto this removable green connector on the side of the charger. We always recommend having a qualified electrician to do the wiring on any circuits that exceed 42 volts. However, if you plan to do this yourself, ensure that it is done correctly. The live wire connects to the right-hand terminal, the neutral wire to the middle, and the earth to the left. Ensure that each wire is securely tightened into the connector terminals and that no part of the wires can short against each other. Secure the earth lead of the charger to the backing plate of the controller housing using the fastener for the charger support strap. The spade connector of the charger earth lead connects onto the controller here. Wire the operators to the controller according to the diagram in the manual. For the slave operator, mount a suitable junction box on the wall for joining the wires coming from the controller housing to the motor. A similar junction box must be provided for the master operator if its wires cannot connect directly into the controller housing. The surge protection provided by the unit relies on an effective earth. Besides ensuring that the main supply is properly earthed back at the distribution board, also tie the earth of the power supply and controller to the chassis plate. To improve the earthing at the operator, install an earth spike right next to the controller housing and connect this firmly to the chassis plate. In areas of high lightning, an additional high current arrestor could be placed on the mains ahead of the charger. The surge arrestor's earth must be well secured to the operator earth. As mentioned previously, all cabling should be screened to give better protection against lightning. Connect the battery leads to the controller without the battery connected and double check this connection. Plug in the charger and switch on the main supply. Finally, connect the battery leads to the battery, once again taking care of the battery polarity. With power on, it's time to set the gate limits.